the way forward for you as a young person. Not to get your brain mashed by a gang who wants to use you and abuse you. They only want to use you so you can go and deal drugs. They only want to use you up. They don't love you, they don't care for you, they're just manipulating you. And you believe they're brainwashing in these gangs. And these gangs do not care about you. These gangs do not care about you. But Jesus cares about you. Jesus loves you. Jesus gave his life for you. Jesus shed his blood for you. He loved you. He died for you. He gave his life for you on that cross. And he wants you to have a new life, a new future, a new purpose. But if you go up with these gangs are going to drug you up. They're going to abuse you sexually. They're going to manipulate you. They're going to brainwash you. And you don't want to be in these gangs. You don't want to have anything to do with these gangs. You need to come out of these gangs and realize that Jesus loves you. And that Jesus wants the best for you. And if you are a gang member and you run a gang, you are a bully if you run one of these gangs. You're not tough, you're not hard. Going around dealing drugs, going around manipulating young people. You're not hard carrying guns. You're not hard carrying knives. You're not hard throwing acid in people's faces. You're a joke, and you need to get rid of the acid attacks. You need to get rid of your guns. You need to get rid of your knives. And you need to stop dealing in drugs. And you need to go to your local church and ask the pastor to teach you the Bible. That's what you need. You don't need to be smoking dope and telling young people to smoke dope. You don't need to be carrying a knife, going around thinking you're hard, going to a nightclub with your mates and thinking you're tough, and then smacking a girl in the face and throwing acid in her face. You're a total disgrace. You're a total joke. God loves you and has got a better life for you. God wants the best for you. He wants to change you and help you and give you a life. You say, Jay, I'm going to knife you up. Well, come on then, bro. Knife me up. Come on then, if you're in a gang, come and knife me up. You're a bully. You're a bully. Put down your knife. Put down your gun. Put down your acid attacks. And try to love people. Try to care for the elderly in your community. Try to do something better with your life. You were made for something better. You were made for a better life. You were made for better. You are destined for greater things. Drug dealing is not what you were destined for. You were destined to be a pastor, a preacher. You were destined to be something better than a drug dealer. You were destined better than fighting on a Saturday night with a knife. You were better than carrying a gun with you. You were better than this. You were better than giving an acid attack. What is that all about? Acid attacks on girls. That is, what are you doing with your life? That is not something you should be doing with your life. You need to come to Jesus and know that Jesus has got a better way for you, a better life for you, a better future for you. He wants to pour his love in you and forgive you. He said, Jay, I've knifed 3 people last week. So what? Repent, you can be forgiven. You can be forgiven even if you've knifed somebody. Even if you punch somebody, you can be forgiven if you repent and believe in Jesus Christ and know that you can be forgiven. You're never lost, my friend. You might feel you're lost in this gang that you're in. That you feel you're in this gang and you're lost and you can't get out of the gang. Listen, you're not lost. Jesus can reach out to you right now and he can change you. So come on. Come on, put the guns down. Put the knives down. Put the acid down. Put the dope down. Put it down, guys. Put it down, girls. And remember how much Jesus died for you. He died on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. He gave his life to you on that cross. I'm going to ask George here, Brother George. What has Jesus done for you, George?
I'll tell you a story of what Jesus has done for me. I'll tell you a story about when I was addicted to drugs. And every day of my life was spent in an endless quest. Trying to get high, trying to change what I saw, how I saw the world. Because the reality that this world gave me had no meaning. There's no value apart from Christ. I thought I was an animal. So who could blame me for living like an animal? But I've got some good news for you today, my friends. You are not an animal. There is a God who made you, who cares for you. You are not just a product of chance. You are special. You are all made in the image of God. No matter what color of skin you are, no matter cogs you are, no matter where you are from on this planet, you are made in the image of God. And don't let anyone else tell you anything differently. Now I'll tell you a story. I used to run, I used to hide from people. I used to be scared of every single person I met. Why? Because I had a spirit of fear in me. I remember going to stand on their bank and lining up and not being able to stand in the queue because I was petrified of everyone. Why? Because I was living in open rebellion. I did not believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. My life was a mess. I was a joke. There was no meaning to anything. And then